Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Vera, I'm from Moscow, Russia. And today I will answer some very strange questions that you asked me about Russia. So, if you're going to visit Moscow one day, this information might be useful for you. So, you asked me where is the best place to change money from dollars to rubles? Well, the first very good advice is to change some small, very small amount of money in the airport. Because, and try to find some kind of bank, not just never change money from people, you know, like people send, oh, I can change money for you. Never do that, never. Only in the official bank. I think it is so obvious, but some people do that weird things. And yes, and then when you will arrive to Moscow, you will live in the hotel. And most of the hotels, they place somewhere in the center of Moscow. So in the center of Moscow, there are a lot of banks like Sberbank. Sberbank is the biggest Russian bank. Sberbank. Сберегательный банк. So, Sberbank. Also, we have Citibank everywhere, and Société Générale Bank. A lot of different international banks. So, if you have your credit card with money, you can go to that bank from which you have this credit card. You can find it in Moscow. It's 90% that you find it, and there you can change money. Also, you ask me, is it better to have cash money or to use credit card or card to pay for something? You know what? My personal advice is that if you clever enough in cash money, I mean, you can check and you can count very well, and you can, you know, realize how much exchange you can have to get. So if you're good with cash money, it's always better to have cash money, because in Moscow there are few places, really few places, where you can pay by card. But in the touristic places, you can, I think, everywhere pay by card. But if you just go to small cafe, or if you go to shop to buy some food, or if you just go somewhere in a bookshop or somewhere not exactly in the center of Moscow, it sometimes might be difficult to buy something without cash money. Or if you go to circle excursion around Moscow, and if you just see something and want to buy something to drink, to eat, some, I don't know, souvenirs or something, always better to have cash money. And what about credit cards? Sometimes and it happens, really, when you pay by card, they may put more money that you had to pay. And if you do not check all the payments you did, so they sometimes do something wrong. So be very careful when you pay by card. Try to check all the payments and check if whether they write or not, because sometimes it happens. Okay, also you ask me, is it safe to go around Moscow by yourself, by feet, by metro, by bus and so on? Well, I should say that in the center of Moscow is quite safe, and if you want to walk around Moscow in daytime, when it's like, you know, daylight and You go in the center of Moscow. It's quite safe. It's very good and beautiful and very safe. But if you will go to some different regions of Moscow, which is not center but somewhere around, it's better to go in small group. It's not really good to go alone, because for instance, you might look different and you might not go to a very safe place because you do not know where is safe place and where is not, and you will be very a sweet person for some criminals. They're not like criminals, but they can steal something from you. They can be not really nice. Sometimes it doesn't happen very like every day and everywhere. Not at all, but it might happen. So it's better not to go far away from the center of Moscow alone. Maybe it's okay if you big man, I mean if you just and look really like sportman or you're really big, but if you're a little girl and you just came to Moscow, it's not a good idea to go like, oh, I will go to the end end station of metro and then just walk out of metro and go here. Not a good idea, actually. Maybe nothing will happen, but I don't know. And the most important advice is try not to go by feet when it's dark. I never do that, you know. I live in Moscow. I was born here. It is my city. But I try never to go for a walk by feet or somewhere in places I don't know. And even in the center of Moscow, after, you know, 11 o'clock in the evening, 12 o'clock in the evening, it just seems not too safe, because a lot of drunk people, especially in the center of Moscow, a lot of drunk people, not like everywhere again, but you can meet them, you know, and it's not really comfortable for me. So try not to do that, try to avoid this. And next thing you ask me, and which is the best place to make some shopping and to buy something in Moscow? And well, if you live in the center of Moscow, the nearest place for you is shopping center Охотный ряд. It's a very cheap place, so if you want to buy something not like luxury and something just average, you can visit Охотный ряд. Охотный ряд, this is a metro station, Охотный ряд, and also it's nearby to Тверская, it's nearby, it's just at the Red Square. So if you are at the Red Square and you see the history museum and you see the monument, and so you are nearby to Охотный ряд. Охотный ряд is just downstairs, and you go downstairs, and under the ground there is a huge shopping center. And also, if you want to buy something more luxury, something more expensive, something more exclusive, and if you want to visit, for instance, Tiffany shop or Dolce & Gabbana or Dior or something, you can visit, we have two great, very big and very beautiful shopping centers. In the center of Moscow is a first GUM, GUM, G-U-M, GUM, the second ZUM. ZUM, like T-S-U-M, ZUM. So they are both huge and they are both like a little bit luxury. And if you buy something special, you can do that. But I should say that prices in Moscow for luxury stuff, not really good. In Europe is much more better. And even if you want to visit Tiffany, it's better to go to United States, obviously. And okay, what else? Is it you asked me about food, where is the best place to eat something in Russia, and it's so many cafes, so many restaurants in the center of Moscow, so I cannot pick one or two. I have a lot of my favorite, but if you want to try something really Russian, like pancakes or kvass or I don't know, something, well, first of all, you can choose fast food cafe. It's like Крошка Картошка, it's called, small potato, Крошка, Крошка Картошка. So this Крошка Картошка is like fast food for like McDonald's, but Russian, very Russian style, Крошка Картошка. There you can buy pancakes, you can buy borscht, you can buy kvass and a lot of Russian things. Also, you can find just typical Russian restaurants or cafes at the Arbat Street or Tverskaya Street or Mesnitskaya Street. There are a lot of them, you know. We have Varenichnaya. Varenichnaya is like typical Russian food. Also, we have it called Russian cuisine cafe. And if you want to try something traditional, very traditional and very exclusive, you can visit Pushkin restaurant. So it's one of